Hey, I'm Joel Crouse, and I'm sitting down with countrymusicrocks.net.
You've been making an impact on country music with the release of your debut single, If You Want Some. Tell us a little bit about yourself and give us a little Joel Crouse 101.
A little bit about myself would probably be I'm from Massachusetts, a really small town, 3,000 people, it's called Holland. And I got into music at a pretty young age, 12, 13. My grandfather bought me my first guitar. He also introduced me to some of the traditional country music artists. And then country music was always around, kind of growing up. And then being from the Northeast, classic rock was always getting played. And so I really liked the Eagles and Fleetwood Mac. So I guess if I had to describe like a sound that I wanted to go with, would be like a blend of the traditional, the contemporary, and also, you know, the kind of classic rock to kind of give it, you know, the melodic harmonies. So I really enjoyed bringing that to country music. And, you know, it's been crazy. I moved to Nashville when I was 18. And it's been a whirlwind. We were on tour with Darius Rucker last year, signed my record deal at 19. This year it was just announced that we're going on tour with Taylor Swift. So that'll be crazy. I mean, it's all really exciting. This is my first single tooted to country radio. And it's insane. It's not real yet, so.
Okay, let's talk about your new single, If You Want Some. Tell us a little bit about that song and what made you choose that as your debut single.
Telling people a lot of this, and it's the last song we wrote for the record, and we were like so deep in the recording and writing process for the rest of the album, which comes out this summer. 10 songs, everything I wrote or co-wrote. And so we were writing and recording all the time, and at the time I was living with 3 other guys in a 2-bedroom apartment. So when we take breaks and everything for the night, we would throw some, you know, pretty cool house parties, apartment parties, whatever. And so one of my last writes was with Luke Laird and my producer Jamie Houston, and he had a kind of a beat going on the computer. We were just talking about what I've been doing lately and like just outside of music. And at the time I was just kind of relaxing, partying, having fun. So that's kind of how the song came about.
Okay. Now your debut album is anticipated for release this year, I believe this summer.
This summer, yeah.
Okay. What has that experience been like for you recording for your debut album?
Well, it's funny, I've been in the studio, you know, pretty much since about 15. Mm-hmm. And so, but to actually have songs that I've written that's getting recorded for a full-length album to be released on iTunes and, you know, to the public is insane. You know what I mean? Because it's my debut of showing people who I am as an artist and the message I want to present, so.
Okay. And tell us a little bit about the album. What can fans expect?
I think they can expect a lot of relatable songs. You know, I try to write from a relatable standpoint and just about everything, you know, I've gone through in life. And so, I mean, they can expect that. And I also love really emotional music as well. You know, things that can, you know, change your mood either from happy or to being sad. And so I think they'll get a good variety of that.
Okay. Now, 2013 is already off to a great start for you. You released your debut single, your album's coming out this summer, and you're hitting the road this spring with the band Perry and also Taylor Swift this summer.
Yeah.
Tell us a little bit about what your first reaction was when you found out you're going out on this major tour with Taylor and playing in your home state of Gillette Stadium.
Yeah, I was in a sushi restaurant in Indiana and my manager called me and I just screamed in the restaurant. And I, you know, not like a girly scream or anything, but yeah, I was freaking out and I look over at Kyle and Brandon, who are my 2 best friends, and I'm just like giving them thumbs up while I'm on the phone in the sushi restaurant. They have no idea what I'm doing or trying to say. And so it didn't feel real, but at the time, I was like, wow, I am incredibly blessed and I'm so thankful for it. So that was kind of it. I mean, it's still kind of surreal. So, you know, I'm trying to work it out, but, you know, we're so excited. And we're so excited to bring a really great set out on Taylor's tour as well.
Very cool. Now, you co-wrote your debut single with well-known songwriters, Luke Laird and Jamie Houston, as you just mentioned. What was that experience like for you writing with songwriters such as Luke, who's written for Eric Church and Blake Shelton?
Yeah,
what
for
was
sure.
that like?
You know, it was a really great opportunity. You know, Luke's BMI Songwriter of the Year. He's super talented, one of the greatest songwriters in town. And I knew we were just going to go in and get a great song, because Jamie and I have worked together for a really long time. So I knew we were just going to all vibe and hang out. The cool thing about songwriters is, you know, when I first moved to Nashville, 17, 18, really intimidated by the songwriters because they're so good. And I definitely was not. But the cool thing is, if you hang around great people and you're not intimidated by it, you know, you're only going to get better. So that's what was cool.
Okay. Now, being such a talented songwriter, if you could write a song and record it with any artist, who would you choose and why?
Ooh. Hold on, I'm going to have to think about that. I think there's a lot of artists I would want to write a song with and record it with, but if I had like a dream to write a song and record it with, it'd be either the Eagles or a couple of the members, you know, Glenn Frey, Don Henley, Joe Walsh. So that would probably be my dream.
Okay.
That'll never happen. So.
Never say never. Music is consistently evolving. In your opinion, what do you think sets country music apart?
The songs. I think, you know, the songs definitely set country music apart because people relate to them and they're still moved by them. And, you know, whether you're going through a breakup, having fun, you know, there's always going to be a song in country music that someone's going to relate to.
Okay. And with 2013 already off to an amazing start for you, what is one of your goals for this year?
I would say my goal for this year is to have fun on tour, you know, really, you know, learn how to entertain people better than I do. And just to release a really awesome record that I hope people will really enjoy.
Okay. And in our interviews, we always like to do 5 quick questions. Will you answer the next 5? First thing you think of.
Okay.
You can't go a day without.
Go.
You can't go a day without.
Listening to music.
Okay. If you could have only one album on your iPod, what would it be?
Rumors by Fleetwood Mac.
Okay. Famous person you would love to get a shout out from on Facebook or Twitter?
Tosh. Why not?
There you go. One thing your fans might be surprised to know about you.
I'm not a fan of the dark.
Okay.
Yeah.
And when you think of country music, what's the first thing that comes to mind?
Songs.
All right, well, thank you for taking the time to chat with us, and I wish you the best of luck with your single and your debut album.
Oh, thank you so much for having me. If you want some, come and get some. We got enough, girl, to go around. Just good friends having a good time. Everybody is a